Hello, traders. Hello, everyone. My name is Grigor Horvat, and welcome to our new episode of Surfing the Elliott Waves, where I will look at some of the most interesting developments for this week. This video has been brought to you by Orbex. I will look at the Euro dollar, dollar CAD, crude oil, gold, New Zealand dollar against the Japanese yen, and a very quick look at dollar Mexican peso. Now, Euro dollar is definitely here in strong uptrend since March, but looks like we are facing some important resistance and reversal on smaller degree time frame charts. Now, the question is if this maybe extended lag from 107.30 is going to be extended wave C, or maybe is it wave three, like shown here on the second wave count. Well, both suggest that we may see at least a retracement to lower prices. Even if it's just wave four, we could, as you know, move all the way back to towards 38.2%. Now, the reason why I'm looking for potential lower prices is also because on the 4 hour here, you can see this broken trend line resistance, meaning that this fifth wave rise from start of July can be coming to an end. And also you have five waves down here on even smaller time frame. So in my opinion, that's either wave one or wave A. You are now in a corrective rise for wave two or wave B, and you could face a reversal back to the downside in the next few sessions. Now, ideal resistance for the sell-off would definitely be at this former wave four around 1.1880 level. Now, let's take a look also on dollar CAD. Now, dollar CAD is also here in downtrend for the last few months, but we are moving here on a weekly chart into some interesting trend line support close to 61.8% of wave A measured from wave B high. So this is very important fib level that comes around this trend line, where this weakness could be limited if we consider that whole price action here from this January 2016 could actually be ongoing triangle. We will see what happens down there, but looking at the 4 hour chart here, I see some very interesting drop from 1.3715. It looks like a five-wave fall that can be coming to an end. In fact, you have here potential ending diagonal, which could still be in the making or maybe already finished at the low. So we will probably know answers in the next few days. If we see a daily close above this 1.3280, then I think that higher prices can come in play. At the same time, obviously, you should keep an eye on crude oil. Now, crude oil for now is still bullish. It could go all the way up towards $44, but the most important price action and structure is definitely here on the daily chart, where we see prices in a fifth wave. But the fifth wave can be an ending diagonal. That's why I'm looking for maybe for another push to the upside, but then you really should be aware of a reversal. Now, when we see this reversal and limited upside on crude oil, that's when dollar CAD could find real buyers. Now, let's take a look also on gold. Now, gold is having bearish development here, it seems, at least in the short term, looking for another dip, because I'm tracking wave four of a higher degree. So looking for a corrective retracement that could move to lower prices. And the reason why I'm looking for more weakness here is because we have a very strong drop here from August highs. Then, more importantly, we had only three wave rise and another five waves of drop here from mid of August. And this looks like a bearish impulse, meaning that more weakness should follow. And so far we have seen only three wave rise in the last few days into this wave four resistance. So it looks like that bears could remain stronger here and potentially even cause a retest of these August lows. So for now, gold is looking to see more weakness, but keep in mind that this is only a corrective pullback and that from lower prices, again, we could be turning very bullish. Now let's take a look also on New Zealand dollar against Japanese yen. Now this one is having some very nice structure on this daily chart, what we see is a bullish reversal in progress, meaning I'm tracking a 5-wave movement. So this was wave 1, you had a wave 2, you had an extended wave 3, and it looks like that we are now in a new wave 4 pullback. Now, wave 4 pullback can find a support at the previous 4th wave, which is here at 68.16 level. Also, there is a 38.2% in this zone as well, so it could be a very nice attractive level for a new bounce. Looking at the 4-hour chart here, you have so far only 3 waves drop, it seems, with potential ending diagonal here for wave C. So maybe another dip is coming, and then watch out for a reversal. Of course, confirmation for push back to the highs would definitely be a decisive break above this trend line resistance of this corrective channel. And also the final market, dollar Mexican peso. Now this one is bearish here on a daily time frame chart since we reversed down from March highs, and looks like that we could see more weakness because this appears to be a triangle here on the way down. I'm not sure if this triangle already have all needed subwaves. Definitely there is a chance that you can count even wave E completed here at this resistance, but I need to see a decisive break below this 21.83 level. If we see a daily close below that level, then I think more weakness will be seen. Of course, this market could be very interesting, maybe even for trading to the downside, especially if suddenly maybe dollar will turn bearish across the board. Okay, traders, thank you very much for your attention. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Talk to you next week. Bye.